Hi everyone, it's Kathy. Thank you so much for joining me. I'm super excited to share this card because when the Chicken Coop die set was released earlier this year, I was super excited about it because I had this idea in my head to turn the Chicken Coop into like a coffee bar or a sideboard. And I kept trying to figure out how I could make that work. And lo and behold, Whimsy Stamps did not disappoint, and they just released the Decorate a Tree die set. And as soon as I saw the Decorate a Tree die set, I thought that is how I'm going to incorporate the Chicken Coop die set and turn that into a buffet or a coffee bar or a sideboard, and then decorate it up for Christmas using the Decorate a Tree die set. So that was my inspiration behind this card and how my idea kind of came to fruition. So let's jump in to actually creating the card. The first thing I did was die cut a piece of very light gray cardstock using the largest die from the Slimline Simple Windows die set. It measures 8.5 by 3.5 once cut, and that will cover the entire front panel of my Slimline card. I used the brick pattern stencil with pumice stone distress oxide ink to create the brick pattern for my background. I die cut two of the trees from the Decorate a Tree die set from white cardstock, and I did a little bit of ink blending with rustic wilderness distress oxide ink. Then to add a little bit of pattern to the trees, I used the micro pattern stamp set and inked that up with the rustic wilderness distress oxide ink. Placed my die cut piece right on top of the stamp and then put a piece of scratch paper on top of that and rubbed over that just to make sure I got a really good transfer of ink. Now the little bows and the ornaments, I die cut those from Cougar Super Smooth cardstock so that I could color them up with my Copic markers. And to get that little loopy look at the bottom of the bows, I used R59 and just colored in the bottom, and I did kind of do a little bit of an arch just to make it look more realistic. Then I colored directly over that with R27 and then added a little bit more of the R59 and then added a second coat of the R27. I'll make sure to have all of the products that I used listed in the description box below for you. And for the little ornament, I wanted one red ornament, so I started with R59 and did that on the outer edges, and then colored in the rest with the R27. To color in the top of the ornament, I used a gold glitter gel pen. For the other two ornaments, I wanted them to be silver, so I just used a silver glitter gel pen for that. And for the tops of those ornaments, I again used the gold glitter gel pen. Next, I colored up the I guess it's garland. Well, for this card, it's garland with a green Copic marker. And I wanted to mention, if you've not yet seen the reveal video for the Decorate a Tree die set, I'll link that at the end of this video so you can actually see all of the pieces that come with the die set, because it is a fantastic die set that can be used so many different ways. Anyway, moving right along. I die cut the word Merry twice from white cardstock and used the same red Copic markers to color it in. I did one with a solid red, and then I tried to do some shading with the R59, and I wasn't liking how that turned out. So I just decided to color over the entire word with the R59. Then when I adhered the die cut words together, I stacked them on top of each other, and I offset the lighter red just a tiny little bit so that darker red would have a little bit of a shadow. Now here is that wonderful chicken coop, and I put the whole chicken coop together. Then I placed it on top of my stenciled cardstock so I could see how far down I needed to have that chicken coop to make sure that I had enough room at the top for my little trees that I had die cut. I made little marks with a pencil, and then I just used my paper trimmer to cut off the bottom of the chicken coop. Next, I adhered my chicken coop to my stenciled piece of cardstock. And to do that, I used a whole bunch of foam tape. Once I had that adhered in place, it was time to add the decorations on the top shelf. I had also die cut one of the smaller trees from silver glitter cardstock, and I used liquid glue to adhere the glitter cardstock to one of the gingham trees, and then I put some foam dots on the back so that it would be flush with my little chicken coop. Once I had the foam dots on the back of my little trees, I brought in the die-cut word Mary as a placeholder, just so I would know where to adhere the little trees. I did put a little bit of glue on the bottom of the trees, just to make sure that they were stuck to the ledge, or the shelf, really well. Once I had my little trees in place, I had to get my little bundle of ornaments ready to go. And I did the same thing with the ornaments as I did with the gingham tree and the silver glitter tree. It's easier for me to adhere all of these tiny little pieces together to make them one piece, so it's easier for me to place it on the front of my card panel. Once I had my little ornaments in place, I put a whole bunch of foam tape on the back of my die-cut word Mary, and again, a tiny dot of glue on the bottom of the Y, and adhered that in place. Next, I used liquid glue to adhere my garland pieces to the very front cabinet of my little chicken coop slash coffee bar. And once I had my garland in place, I used liquid glue to adhere all of my tiny little bows. Once my bows were adhered in place, I used liquid glue on the back of my card panel to adhere to the front of my slimline card base. My card base started out at 8.5 by 7. I scored it at 3.5 inches on the 7-inch side. So my finished card is 8.5 by 3.5. To finish it up, I added a little bit of shimmer to the die-cut word Mary and my little bows by using my Wink of Stella glitter pen. And that's it. That finishes up my video for today. Thank you so much for joining me. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you've not yet subscribed, we'd love it if you would. And don't forget to ring the bell so you're notified every time a new video is posted. Thanks again, and we'll see you next time.